Hi, today I'm going to show you how to knit this mitten. Let's get started. Cast on multiple of 2. I made 36. My hands are really tiny, so 36 is big enough for me. But if you are making bigger size, make sure it fits you. Maybe 52 for men, something like that. Make sure it fits you. Start making rib. Knit around so you connect both ends, and I'm just showing you step by step how to do it because this project is very small, so I just making sure how to do it. Just spread the stitch in half like that and pull the one needle which attached to the yarn, then start knitting. Okay, rib row should be repeat of knit one and purl one until your desired length. I made 3 inches long. I made 3 inches rib. Then now you change the needle from 4 to 5. After the rib, you start increasing row. But just before increasing row, which is thumb gathet, you just knit around, no increasing for couple rows. I did 3 rows until at the very bottom of the thumb. Okay, here's the thing. I just knit 3 rows. Just knit around. So the wrist and there. So you cover that part. Then now you start increasing row, which is thumb gathet. Okay? So if you have a bigger hand, you might have to knit a couple more rows. So that's the gusset, okay, the thumb. thumb gusset. Place the beginning marker. This is preparation row. Knit one, then make one left, which is you pick up the running thread from front, then knit back of the yarn. Okay, that's make one left, then knit one. Next, make one right, pick up running thread from back, then knit. It's a little bit tight, but just knit there. That's make one right, then knit one. That's knit one, make one left, knit, then make one right. Okay, after make one right, I did make knit one. So two stitches increase, then place the marker, then knit around. Then as you can see, row 2 and row 3 is all knit, just knit, knit, knit. Thumb gusset is repeat of row 1 to row 3. Now row 1. Knit 1, then make one left, and knit until one last stitch before the marker. There you go. Then make one right. After make one right, knit one. Then slide the marker. After that, just knit around. Then row number 2 and row number 3 is all knit. Again, you have to knit thumb gusset until the place in between bottom of the thumb and index finger. Just like that, right there. And you connect right there to make the thumb. Okay, so you really have to knit until there. Once you reach the desired length for thumb, you are now separating the thumb with thread. You really have to watch carefully here because you have to pick two extra. One at the beginning, right there, running thread, and one at the end. Pick up one like that, then pick all the stitch until the marker. Then you have to pick one more running thread. So watch my video carefully. And why you doing this? Because I want to limit the gap around the thumb later. There you go. And just leave the thumb alone right now. You have to knit the full finger parts. I'm just showing you how it looks right now. That's the thumb. And the bigger part is four other fingers. There you go. Then now you knit around for the four finger parts. However, you need to add cast on. I add one because my finger is very thin. But if you have thicker hands, maybe you want to add a couple more. It all depends on your hand size. After you add cast on, you just knit around and around. And as you already know, I want to make a hole for index finger. So knit around until at the second joint of index finger. I'm just making sure it fits me and it's perfect. And right there, I have to knit around until second joint. Okay? And if you don't want to make the hole, you just skip this part. But I love this hole. So you can use your cell phone. Okay. You need to bind four off right after the beginning marker. Okay? Four stitch bind off. Second and third, then four. Then knit one around. Here comes next row. Because you bind four off, now you add four cast on right top of the four bind off. Okay? You have to add four new cast right above the bind off, then knit till end. And now you just knit around and around and around until top of the index finger. Once you hit the top of the index finger, then you're going to decrease. So make sure all your finger will be covered. Okay? This is additional information. For left-hand people, you have to bind four off just before the beginning marker. Okay, this is different. Left and right. Okay, and everything else is all same. I knit enough, then I'm going to start decreasing row. Place the marker right in the middle from beginning, okay? Decreasing row is so easy. To start, knit one. Then SSK, slip, slip, knit. Slip, slip, knit. This is one stitch decreased. Then after SSK, knit until last three stitch before the next marker. Okay? Then those three stitch, you have to K2 tag, which is knit two together, then knit one. Okay, last three stitch, knit two together, then knit one. And you have to repeat until about 10 stitches remain. Again, knit one SSK, knit the last three stitch before the marker, and knit two together, then knit one. On and on and on. Again, if you're making bigger size, you might have to adjust a couple rows, like maybe in between decrease row, you wanna add one knit row, stuff like that. Make sure shape is all good. Also, when you're making one hand, I mean first hand, you have to write it down how many stitch you made. Otherwise, for second hand, you have to start all over. If you write everything down, it's so easy, you don't have to think. You just follow your, you know, the record. Okay? Now, let's start thumb. Okay? Don't forget that extra running thread you picked earlier, and you transfer onto cable needle. There we go. And the pink marker right there, do you remember you add one stitch to connect? Okay, there's one stitch extra there. Now you knit up. People sometimes think, okay, you add one stitch, so why don't we knit up one? No, you actually knit up a little bit of extra. That's because you want to minimize the gap right there. So I add three, I mean, you know, knit up three instead of one. Okay? Knitting thumb is very straightforward, except the first row because of the extra stitch right there. Pick up that stitch and twist it back onto the left needle, then knit two together there. Everything what I'm doing for this is just minimize the gap around the thumb. Just minimize. You can't get rid of it, but don't worry about it. And anyway, knit until last two stitch, which include the extra stitch. You want to twist last extra stitch, so pick one, then twist the extra stitch, then put the stitch back on, then SSK, slip, slip, knit. Then after this, straight forward, knit around until top of your thumb. I knit enough for thumb. Now, one last row. Repeat of knit two together. Repeat of knit two together. Just one row. That's about it. There's still a little gap around the thumb, so whenever you leave the ends, you knit up around there to cover the gap. This was so easy, just one day project, great idea for Christmas gift, still you can make it. Please enjoy knitting. Bye for now.